Guys, I've officially did it, man. I have officially tried out and got a Warzone win with the tryhard sweaty Growl 556 class setup that you guys know. I mean, this class setup is used by the pros. I mean, you got Swag, Nick, Mercs, Priesta, Abizi, Vicstar, all of them, bro. This has basically been the most overpowered class setup for Warzone in general for the longest time, basically since day one when it came out. All I gotta say though, man, is in a few words, this gun is an absolute laser beam. It does lack at close range a little bit, but you guys will see in the gameplay, man, I won gunfights point blank to kids with a Vector, bro. Literally the SMG that shreds, and I won literally barrel stuff gunfights with the Growl. If you guys enjoy the video at any point, man, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. As you guys can tell, basically 95% of my viewers watch my videos but are not subscribed to the channel. It literally takes 1 second and it's free, man. You guys get all the Warzone multiplayer content, best class setups, tactical nukes, and on top of that, here's the post notification shout out. If you guys want to win one in a future video, be sure to, of course, hit the sub button, ring the notification bell. Once you guys are finished, comment down below, hashtag Bellgang, and I will give you guys a personalized shout out. The last time I asked for 50 likes, you guys smashed that within like 12 hours. So if you guys can do that once again, man, please be sure to drop a like. But yeah, guys, basically, we're going to be starting with the Naked Growl and just building it from scratch. And pretty much all my class setups, I put on the Universal Monolithic Suppressor. It's pretty much what you want to use on every single AR and SMG. That's a given at this point. If you guys watch my videos, if you haven't already, I use this pretty much on every single one of my guns because it keeps you off the minimap and gives you some damage range. In the previous Growl class setup, I actually didn't use the Monolithic Suppressor and it was still good, but like I said, you will appear on the minimap. So just with that factor, it makes you more stealthy, and at end games, it is 100% worth it. So just for that sake, I would definitely have it on. Next up, man, the attachment that pretty much ties the entire class setup together, we got the Tempest 24.6 Archangel Barrel. Now, this barrel is insane, man. A lot of people also resort to the Nexus. Now, the thing with these two is that they both have different iron sights. Pretty much the only difference between the Archangel and the Nexus barrel is that with the Archangel, you guys are going to have more extreme statistics, meaning that you guys are going to have higher pros and lower cons. And with the Nexus barrel, you guys are going to have higher pros and lower cons. So basically, the Archangel barrel just makes it more extreme. Next up, we have the Commando foregrip. Pretty much every single other grip is unnecessary. The other attachments that you would probably see on the Growl is either the Merc foregrip or the tactical foregrip. However, those attachments are just unnecessary. It's going to help with the overall recoil control and reduce ADS sway. So let's say you have a far away target, it's going to make sure to reduce the ADS sway. So essentially, you're not going to be having to struggle when hitting your shots at long ranges. Right here, guys, to counter all the ADS speed nerfs that all the other attachments had, make sure to put on the XRK Void 2 to make sure that you guys have a little bit more ADS speed than you usually would. Because like I said, a lot of the other attachments already decreased the ADS speed a ton. And then guys, for the final attachment, go and put on the 60 round mags. It's tradition to put on the highest capacity magazine because you guys are gonna have to fire so many bullets, especially if you're in trios or quads, man. So many people at once that you can run into, and you want to make sure that you don't run out of ammo. Now, in conclusion, with this class setup, I would not recommend using it at close ranges at all. However, if it is necessary, you guys can possibly win gunfights. This gun is extremely lethal at long ranges though, which is where I would recommend it. I personally run an overkill SMG class, whether it be the Fennec or the MP5, and that always works out at close ranges. But for long ranges, always use the Growl, man. You're gonna get the kills basically instantly.
UAV entering the AO.
Holy. Moving.
Be advised, UAV is bingo fuel. RTB for resupply.
Dude, I don't know how many people are fucking here.
You're done. Time to earn your freedom, soldier.
Target marked. Let him have it.
This is Striker 3-1. Good copy. Strike inbound. No hits on that.
Advised, UAV is bingo fuel. RTB for resupply. UAV is bingo fuel. RTB for resupply.
Enemy UAV overhead. Gas is moving in. New safe zone located. Bounty target is down.
Moving.
Be advised, UAV is bingo fuel. Our team is for resupply.
Close.
Oh, that's it.
That's good.
Mission accomplished. All targets eliminated.
GG, man.